G'day, I'm Coach Cole. Welcome to the new world of sport. We're a radio station that likes to broadcast live, but we're going innovative. And like my protege Clarko, we're punching holes in the walls of the entertainment industry. We've decided to film the show so you, the viewer, and you, the listener, can come together as one. And remember, if it bleeds, you can kill it.
Courage, strength, and an irresistible urge to wear tight shorts. These are the keys to success in our great Australian game of football. A game where bleeding was banned until 1972 and knitted socks just 2 years later. But for those of us unable to wrestle with an orangutan or an unshaven Cameron Ling, there is always the chance to grow hair on your upper lip and present the new world of sports.
I love it when you grab them, a jiggle and a slap them, my jingle balls.
And that was Mikhail Bublé's Jingle Balls from his new album, I'll Be Seeing Your Mother Behind the Christmas Tree. You're listening to the new world of sport, 169.57. This Savo on your drive home, Gavo, what happened last night, son?
Cole, yeah, thanks. I just want to address what happened on the show yesterday. As you know, our very popular segment, Players with Animal Nicknames, went really well, no problems whatsoever. But overnight, on our socials, on the station's socials, a video was put up of you and I with some of the animals from the nicknames in compromising positions. And what made it worse was there was added pleasure sounds. These videos then featured myself uttering very derogatory statements, Cole. We just want to make it known to our listeners that our socials were hacked last night, and the video that many women, families and children, Cole, saw was a fake video. It was posted on our pages by hackers, and our station had absolutely nothing to do with it, but we do apologise for any offence caused, Cole.
Well, Gav, I mean, what? We had horse, we had roo, we had duck. Surely the listeners and the people out there know that a John Cock and a Dick Foss are not animals. I mean, those photos were ridiculous.
Well, I don't think it helps, Cole, that you kept saying that phrase yesterday.
What? Pheasant plucker? It's just bloody funny.
Cole, we've had a stern talking to by the AFL. This is a serious matter. I just want to let the listeners know that the police are currently involved.
Well, I'm sure your father can just smooth it over with Gil for us, Gav.
Well, regardless of who's been talked to and who's been brought in, Cole, I just want it known that it shouldn't have been on our socials. We were hacked. We would never have posted disgusting images like that. And it does not represent our station in any way, shape or form. And I would put my journalistic reputation on the line over our innocence in this, Coach.
It's AI gone mad. That's what it is. Well, let's just leave it at that.
Yeah, we're going to go to a song. It's Baha Men with Who Let the Dogs Out?
Woof. Woof, 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 woof.
Who let the dogs out?
And you're back here on the New World of Sport, 169.57 on your run home this afternoon. You're listening to the Coach and Gav. Coach, the biggest sporting news for this past week, how good were the Matildas? 11 million people watched the game. Bit disappointing?
No, they were amazing, Gavin. Don't get me wrong, I love what they did. They were able to unite the nation, but hardly the hot topic of this week.
Okay.
Well, you haven't you heard? Koch and Riewoldt?
Yeah, they're retiring. Big congratulations, champions of the Richmond Football Club.
Retiring, Gav.
What are you saying, Cole?
They're heading north. They're not retiring. They're joining Dimmer up at the Gold Coast.
What are you talking about?
I'm telling you, I have it on good authority from my sources. No, listen.
What are these sources, Coach?
I'm telling you. Cochin, Riewoldt, they've made way so they can move up the coast. And they're forming the nucleus of what will be a force to be reckoned with, Gav.
Okay.
With Dimmer at the helm. I tell you, he's searching for that elusive fourth premiership, and he'll get it at the Gold Coast. You know why?
Why?
Guess who else is going up there?
I have no idea.
Have a think about it. Cochin.
Yep.
Riewoldt. Who else would you take?
Dusty.
Exactly. Not only Dusty. They're not only taking Dusty, Gav.
You go.
Actually, Prescott's going back to the Gold Coast.
Are you serious?
I'm telling you, he's had enough of Claremont. He's going back to the Gold Coast. Miranda's going to join him.
You're serious
Wayne
with this?
Wayne Campbell, Nick Duffy. I'm telling you, Nick Duffy, Wayne Campbell, midfield coaches. Kellaway in the back line.
Well, you've got absolutely sorted. You should go up there as the assistant coach.
Well, maybe I should. I totally agree with you, Gav.
Oh, next you're going to tell me Barmy's going up as the team manager, footy boss.
No, I totally agree with you, Gav. But isn't it funny how we can see it, but those guys on the Sunday footy show, they can't see the footy from the bloody sticks. I mean, what game are they watching?
Well, you're right, Coach. TJ and Kano are watching themselves. I mean, half the content and their expert opinion from their whole show has been regurgitated from our show all year long.
Here, bloody here, Gav.
But it's that time for an update, Coach, brought to you by Solar Gain, your solar energy specialist. Let's cross to the news.
Hi, I'm Hannah Sainty, and this is the New World of Sports News News Update. The final of the AFL National Scrabble Championship was decided today, with Adam Uze emerging victorious over Jacob Kaczynski. Reigning champion Ilija Grkić decided not to defend his title after losing an eye in training. Mr. Uze said he will be celebrating the win with a big night on the tiles. In other news, a combination of current and former players from the Western Bulldogs have joined forces to open a new coffee place in the western suburb of Footscray. Danny Southern, Easton Wood and Riley West have launched Cafe Compass, bringing new coffee from every corner of the globe.
Oh, imagine if John Northey went in there, the whole place would be in all directions. Never eat soggy Weet-Bix.
And finally, the answer to the question everyone has been asking, how many pickled peppers did Sam Powell Pepper pick? 7. And that's all the news for today.
Oh, thank you, Hannah. That was a lovely read. And it's your last day today.
Yes, I'm going on maternity leave.
Oh.
Who's going to read the news for us now? Tony Jones?
Oh, Gav, why don't we play the song I wrote for the man himself, for Tony Jones?
Oh, yes, yes. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here it is, Coach Cole's latest smash hit.
He's the man with pearly whites on the footy show. Tried to kiss old Juddy's wife. Oh, dear, oh, no. Rejected constantly and left so awkwardly. Chompers, chomp, chomp. Walk by after shaking his hand. It's Chompers, chomp, chomp. Things don't always go as planned for Chompers. The man with big shiny teeth. The boys always give him grief. We love him all the same. It's Chompers, chomp, chomp. Channel 9's mistake a man. It's Chompers, chomp, chomp.
Thanks for coming in, Hannah, and good luck on your little holiday.
Thank you.
We're going to go to a commercial.
So here you're looking to invest.
Who the hell are you?
I'm Mark Zanotti from ZanottiPonzi.com. Here at Zanotti Ponzi, we guarantee 100% return on every dollar you spend. Real estate, it's yours.
Hey, crypto, come and get it.
We cover everything.
Coaches getting sacked, players getting moved. What's the next sex scandal? What do you think I am, a f***ing asshole?
Money is everything, boy, and you're gonna need some.
Just remember, your money is safe at ZanottiPonzi.com, P.O. Box 625-472, Mallorca, Spain.
And welcome everyone back to New World of Sport 169.57 on your dial. We're in the studio today with an absolute great of the Richmond Tigers. He's played 113 games. He's one of the great men of football. I taught him how to kick it back in the day. And no, I did. All the way from Kyabram, the P-Train himself, Mr. Kayne Pettifer.
G'day, Kayne. Welcome into the show, mate. We haven't had you in for a while. We do apologise for that, but you're here now. How are you, mate? We haven't caught up with you for a number of years. What's been happening?
No, life's great. P train's flying, so
yeah,
it's obviously post footy's been great. Got the few businesses going on now, and which
kind of business? What have you been doing?
Got the pub and nightclub out in Ringwood there, which is going well.
That's
so got the tattoo parlour with Kingy. So it's probably the only one in Melbourne hasn't been shot up yet, but that's going well. Obviously got the tower crane business now. So obviously with I thought I'd get involved in that with the amount of hangers I took patrolling the airways.
You love being up high, don't you, mate?
Yeah, really high.
Careful how you say that.
Okay,
stuff like that. We don't condone any use of drugs here at New World of Sport 169.57 if you are listening.
Yes, and I got the gym, so health and fitness. So obviously got the share in a few gyms, which has been great. Obviously kept the rig intact.
You look great, mate. Yeah. You look great.
Look good, feel good, as they say.
As they do say. What gets you up in the morning? What gets you hard in the morning? What's your passion?
Probably the new business that I've
another ABN.
Another ABN.
Yeah, right.
Yes,
go
which
on.
Is which is obviously just another one to the
list.
The growing list.
Yeah, but, up to about yeah, seven, is, I think.
Yeah, it's about seven there. But this one's obviously it's my passion.
Right.
It's got the last name involved, stuff like that. So I've got a bit of a
What is the business, Kayne?
It's called Kayne's Petting Furs.
Right.
So what?
Kayne's Petting Furs. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's
interesting.
Yeah. I'll just give a bit of a rundown. I've got a bit of a spiel on it here. If you want me to.
Is
this exclusive?
Yeah, a bit of an exclusive break.
Here you go, ladies and gentlemen. You're going to hear this first.
Do you like comfort? Do you like petting animals? Are you scared animals will attack? Well, look no further than my furs, Kayne's Petting Furs. They're the best furs you can pet. Get your hands on my furs. Sourced from the best ethical vegan dead and bloodied animals we could find. If there's a dead animal on the side of the road, you betcha, I'll grab it and I'll pet it. Kayne's Petting Furs, as many to choose from.
Right. Interesting kind of business there, Kayne.
Yeah, sounds amazing, Kayne. Yeah. Great. You must be happy.
So what kind of, like, when you're saying different kinds of furs, what do you mean?
Oh, we sort of specialise in all types of furs, but I've brought a few here if you want to. If you want to go through them and have a bit of a look at it.
Please, absolutely, take the stage.
Beautiful. So I just brought the suitcase here of the, these top three selling items at the minute.
Yeah, right, let's have a look.
So I've got the KB, the Kevin Bartlett.
Right, yes.
Yeah, so obviously nice, fur to stroke. Can do a lot with it over the shoulder if you want to have a go.
I'm guessing like people that are allergic to animals.
Yeah, yeah,
because there are a lot of allergies these days. You can't even eat a bloody peanut.
No.
No.
So that's that's the top seller at the minute, the KB.
Right, imagine so. Yeah. A bit more hair than KB, though.
A bit more hair. Yeah. Flows like KB's hair.
Right,
the back.
Brilliant. Wow, so it is good
at
the
shoulder. That's a beauty, that one.
I'll just leave that up there then.
Yep. We've got the Peter Dacos.
Wow.
Great. Wow. Classic. Amazing. Yeah.
Absolute Dacos, like obviously back in the day you had the rug flowing.
Yeah.
The Macedonian Marvel, as they used to call him, and this is absolutely marvelous as well, like Peter. So if you just want to have a bit of a rub there, stroke that one.
Gavin,
that's real.
Remember that one, Gavin?
Okay, that's
it's good.
Brilliant.
Yeah, and then the last two that has taken people by storm is the Dacos Brothers. So the Dacos Brothers, this selling combo's been huge.
Right, the mini Dacos.
The mini, so a little bit smaller than the father.
Yeah.
Put them together, what do you get, Gav? The Holy Trinity.
Yeah, that's a father, son, and the holy boots.
You can buy obviously individually, but you buy the three and we give you a great discount.
Where can you buy these?
Surely the Pies would want to knock these off. You got in touch with them.
We're opening a retail store on Swan Street there, so obviously a lot of the fans come down there. So obviously we'll have them hanging in the windows.
Yeah, I can see
that. Beautiful.
Great. Yeah, like that. Perfect.
Amazing, Kayne.
Eddie would love these.
Oh, Eddie's bought a few already.
I can imagine. Carl and the kids would absolutely be all over this. Amazing. Right.
Yeah, I was just going to sort of finish off a bit of our cat's cry type thing for the business.
You're not allergic to them, are you?
No, they're great. They're absolutely, they're great.
I thought you said they weren't like non-allergic.
Yeah, they're supposed to be, yeah. Right. Yeah, they should be.
Are they natural, Kayne? These are natural?
Yeah. They're naturally, as I said, we get them from anywhere off the side of the road.
Sorry to interrupt you, Kayne. Go ahead, mate. We have got heaps of time.
Yeah, cool. Thanks, Gav. So, yeah, our marketing the slogan is, if Kayne doesn't pet it, it's not worth petting. Because my name is Kayne Pettifer. From Kayne's petting
First. No, that's all right. That's all right, Kayno. P-Train, we've just got that dump button there ready. Yeah, it's fine, mate. It's fine. It's okay. The producer's just saying we've got to go to a song. We're going to go to Pet Shop Boys, Go West.
KB, absolute Richmond icon, so I thought I'd kick it off with that.
Well, speaking of Richmond icons, are you going to do a Matty Richardson fair at all?
Nah, wouldn't waste any time.
No?
What was
that, mate?
Oh, I just saw the whinging and carry on. Like, did he put on the field, throwing his arms in the air? Like, what about me? What about me? Abusing us blokes, we're hitting him lace out and he's dropping them.
Yeah, right.
What I'm supposed to do. I wouldn't. Yeah, piece
not
of
the
that bloke.
Yeah.
Wait, are you bullshitting? Is this dead set?
Richer, yeah.
Yeah.
Absolute head.
Really?
Yeah, he's a full blown weed. So.
Wow, okay. Strong.
Oh, truth hurts, and that's just what it is around the club. That's just, all us boys thought that, but obviously him being the big top dog and player and on all the big money, we'd sort of suck up to him because he shares a few beers going out now and then. So.
I'm not going to doubt you, Kayne.
Well, the producer telling us to get back on air, guys, so let's...
All right, we are back here, New World of Sport, with the coach and Gav on your Arvo drive home. We're here with Tigers superstar, Kayne Pettifer. Welcome again, Kayne. It's been great having you on. What was off air? What was that story you're telling us about the old mate Richo?
The big Cho, one of the greatest guys ever to come out of football. Obviously most loved. You can tell by everywhere he goes, everyone doing the big Richo chants, but everyone just loves him. I personally, he's my best mate to come out of footy.
Yeah,
spent
yeah,
a lot right. of great times travelling overseas.
Not a bad word to say about him ever.
Not a bad word at all, mate.
Love
he's,
him.
Soul of the earth type of guy.
Yeah, right.
Big heart, do anything for you.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
Great guy.
I love Richo.
Yeah, absolute star.
Yeah, no, I agree. He's an absolute love the bloke. Legend. Lovely love. Man.
All right, we're going to go to Richard Clapton's Best Friends Forever.
Welcome back. You're listening to the New World of Sport 169.57. It is time for...
Cheeky Sedge for a Cheeky Sledge.
That's right, folks. It's a Cheeky Sedge for a Cheeky Sledge. We've got the Sedgley and Sons wine. They're our friends down at Hotel Loner in Lona St Kilda. And this is where we ask you, Kayne, what's the cheekiest sledge you've heard or received on the footy field?
It was probably off the footy field. Biggest sledge I copped off the great Terry Wallace.
Terrence.
Yeah. We played Hawthorn down at Launceston Oval, down there in Richo's homeland. And I didn't have a bad game, had 25 plus touches, kicked three, and we ended up getting done when we were supposed to win. So we had our aftermatch, and usually everyone sort of sits in their seats, but I decided to come and sit up the front, right in front of the great Plough, and sat there, and Plough and I got on pretty well, and I sat in front of him, and chest back, shoulders back, chest out, and he's going through everyone. Then he gets to the end and goes, and you, and I thought, he's going to tell me, put on a clinic today. He's kicked three, had 25, probably got a Brownlow vote, who knows.
Yes.
He's like, and you call yourself the pea plane. He goes, you're more like a pea brain, and threw a texter right in my forehead, bounced off and went down. The whole room went quiet, and
just bounced straight off the
head, and then Richo's just lost and started laughing, and everyone started laughing. He goes, get out. And I walked out absolutely shattered.
That is a sledge and a half, mate.
Yeah,
I love that.
Copped
the P train, the P brain. And it reminds me of the G train, the old Fraser Gehry.
So many
trains and planes and automobiles. But me and the G train, we used to have a bit of fun at the Moorabbin Disco. A bit of dancing. We did a Nutbush together.
When they said you didn't have it anymore.
Yep. Oh, Terry Wallace. Yeah. Tezza. Mate, I can't hear you. You've got a bad line there. What do you mean that's your voice? No, 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 yes. Now, I'll let him know. Oh, you said something else, did you? Right. No, I'll let him know. He's right here. Yeah. Righto. Yes. No problems. I'll get the solarium sent out to you on Wednesday. Okay. See you, mate. So, we were just talking about that sledge before.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he didn't reckon he called you a pea brain. He reckons he said something totally different. Right? Yes. Okay. Let's get back on air. We'll get back to it, mate.
We're back on New World of Sport. Cole, what have we got next?
It is that time for the reading of a romance novel, Kayne. This is one of our long-time listeners, Beryl D. Lovin. She's written a romance novel about the great Gary Lyon, from Kyabram as well, your neck of the woods.
Yep.
There it is. She is a best-selling author. This is her romance novel, and it's got Gary there. The book's called Every Heart Beats True, A Lion's Tale. So if you could maybe read us an excerpt today, Kayne, that would be great.
As skipper, Gary was fed up. He was disgusted at the state of his once mighty ship, the Leoncelli. It reminded him of Melbourne's 2022 season, one which promised silverware but delivered no booty, and Gary loved booty. Something had to be done. He decided to climb the lookout and take a series of photos and send deck pics to his crew. He sent a deck pic to his first mate. He sent deck pics to his master gunner. He even sent deck pics to the cabin boy. Then he yelled across the ship, "I can't stand these filthy, dirty oars." Sensing his frustration, Beryl approached Gary from behind and lay a hand on his shoulder. It reminded him of how Stephen Silvani used to play him close from behind. He could feel his frustration dissipate as Beryl whispered into his ear, "That's quite a swell there, Gary. Why don't you put the naughty back in nautical?"
Amazing read.
Beautiful, yeah.
There it is, yeah. Every Heart Beats True, A Lion's Tale, at all your best-selling bookstores. Thank you, Gav. Kayne, thanks so much for coming on. You've been an absolute honour to have you here. We love what you're doing with your new business, and we'll promote it any way we can. Guys, can we get that up on our websites and stuff?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes, we can. Kayne's petting first. Mate, now, normally Dipper would be doing this, so I'm going to have to do this myself, but just bear with me while I go and get some goodies for you, mate.
Thank you.
Our way of saying thanks for coming in.
I appreciate it.
Hang there, mate. Hang five. We've got some amazing gifts for you, Kayne. We've got, this is great. I mean, you gave us it today. We're going to get you to take it home. It's the Sedgley & Sons Pinot Noir, all the way from our good friends at Hotel Owner. Look at that beautiful bottle of wine.
Thank you.
This also comes with a nice $300 voucher from our friends at St Kilda, Lona and Lona Hotel. And that's Ed, Mel and Charles down there. Tell them I said g'day.
Beautiful.
$300 voucher. Have a look at that. That is a beauty. Take the family there. Get a nice feed. Sedgley & Sons wine. We got more. Kayne, that's not it. I mean, bloody Dipper, if he was here, he'd be doing this. So I don't have to bloody get out of the seat all the time. But, mate, this is one of my... this is one of my brews, mate. It's a premiership lager.
Wow.
Comes in a four-pack. I won four premierships, as you know. That's for you to enjoy when you get home and you just want to kick the feet up and watch the footy, mate. Some premiership lager. Enjoy that. That's great.
No.
We got more, Kayne. That's not all for you. As a thanks for coming on the show, these are... Now, you have been sipping out of one, but this is one you can take home with you. I mean, pick it.
Yeah, do you want that one or do you want a new one?
Whatever you want. Oh, it's a New World of Sport mug, mate. Take that for your coffees in the morning. And very limited run of shirts, mate. The Signature Series Coach Cole shirt, mate. You're going to look great in that.
Brilliant.
Great with a bit of your petting furs over the top. They just go well together.
Yeah.
And what else have we got here? We got the last thing, mate, from our friends at Bataki Small Goods. Clear the desk there for us, Gav.
Yeah, sorry, mate.
Yeah, I'm sorry, mate. Like I said, Dipper normally does this, but we don't know where he's been. This is the Bataki. Have a look at this, mate. Have a look.
Wow, look at this.
Jeez, that's a nice material, isn't it?
Is that a fur?
No.
Is that one of your furs?
No, that's one of my ex-teammates from his last haircut. Brownie, starting to lose a bit.
Yeah, right. Well, as I was saying, mate, our friends at Bataki, have a look at this, mate. You've got a double cream brie. You've got a big bloody sausage that I don't know how to pronounce. You've got an Aussie bit of bacon. Mate, you could make a plowman, Terry Wallace Plowman's bloody lunch out of this. Look at this, mate. Oh, the Kaiser Flesh.
Wow.
Is it Kaiser Fleesh?
Kaiser Soze.
Kaiser Soze, the old unusual suspect. Sweet fig. We've got Bataki. and an authentic leg ham. You've just got everything. Camber Bay, Kransky's, you've got bloody ham.
Just look down the camera there too while he's doing this, Kayne.
But talking ham, Kayne, thanks so much for coming in. It's been an absolute honour, mate.
No, thank you. Really appreciate it. And thanks to Bataki and all the sponsors.
Yeah. Righto. Thank you. Gav, no, you're doing it wrong, mate. You never use a wood on a par three. Everyone knows we go with an iron. Now, just keep your head down, and it's all in the hips. Watch the follow through.
Yeah, okay.
You got this. Oh, Gav. You are hopeless.
The wood was better.